This is ZNS Total Sports, brought to you by Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Welcome to sports, everybody. There are less than 12 days to go now until the start of the inaugural IAAF World Relays. Last Thursday, the B3As released a list of runners who will represent the 242 when the world invades our shores May 24th and 25th. Now, some noise has been made in the marketplace, but boss Mike Sands says he expects good results from the Bahamas and he expects them to defend their home turf.
Some persons may think that we're late, but trust me, we're not late. We have developed that synergy with the team, and we want to be able to isolate them for the next 10 to 14 days, and their focus, perhaps twice a day, will be on getting the relay team gelling, because you can't finish that relay unless you have the baton in your hand.
Still talking track and field, Bianca Stewart was in Guadeloupe over the weekend competing in the women's long jump. She finished second with a leap of 21 feet 7.5 inches. And moving forward, she says there's still a couple of adjustments she wants to make.
It's just my last two steps to the board, the penultimate off the board, and just extending my legs because I have the speed. I have enough speed to get me down the runway. So it's just those last two steps that'll give me the extra distance.
Come Christmas Eve, college football will take center stage at the Thomas A. Robinson National Stadium with the staging of the inaugural Bahamas Bowl. One of the teams will come from Conference USA, and according to executive Richard Gianni, this will be a much-needed football game, and it will be much more than football taking place.
I think this is a win-win for everybody. I think that that our student-athletes will have a tremendous time down here. And they want to give back. They don't want to just come down here and play a football game. They're going to come down here, and we want to hold a clinic. We want to get involved with you, Mel, and your group, and have a clinic for the youth here. And we want to leave something here that'll be a tradition and something that you can build on. And football, the game of American football, can really grow and prosper in this country.
The Abaco Softball Association opened up its 2014 season over the weekend. Our Charles Fisher had a front row seat.
It was the six-footer Lyle Sawyer just back from Cali, Colombia with the men's national softball team. So you know he's in mid-season form, working and mowing down the Hopetown records early. Also got some timely hits. And what was a close 6-1 early ball game turned out to be a one-sided affair as the defending national champs, Crater Bulldogs, got off with a big bite, winning 22-2.
Yeah, we did pretty good. Done a little bit better, but we did all right.
You probably were in better shape than most of us who just come back from Colombia.
Yeah, I was. I mean, I've been working out all off-season, and I could have kept pitching. I mean, I'm in pretty good shape right now.
We come out a little flat. First game of the season, maybe getting in the groove. We'll be sharp coming in next game after we split the champions. But we played them pretty good tonight, but trust me, we'll coming for them. We'll be sharp, be ready for them the next time. We see some good signs for a team that just come out for a second, yeah. But you can see we could beat them with ease.
Now to the ladies, where the rule this year is 5 innings or hour and a half time limit, whichever comes first. And back on the diamond was the defending ladies champ, Abaco Grocery Diamond Dolls, who came out swinging and were not good ambassadors at all, welcoming harvest time major pain to the league, who definitely felt the pain, losing 12-2 in 5 innings. Juanette Lewis and Coach George Knowles liking the start.
We came out here to prove that we were champions, we are champions, and we're going to remain champions this year.
You know, you guys now have a target on the back. What is going to keep you all on top of those standings now with these other teams coming out for you?
Well, we have rebuilt our team. We have a lot of old players that came back. So now we are looking forward to winning this championship, and we are waiting for the round robin tournament.
Came back this season, got everybody in condition, and we came this is where we are now, and we want to remain this. We're on top, and we can stay on top.
For the husband and wife coach-player combination of Dwayne and Nikita Reckley.
But you got to get all them jitters out of yourself, so I couldn't make too much noise tonight, but they did a good job in the ending part of the innings. So it was good in my all fair to me.
It's a learning experience, and I hope that we come out next week with better intentions and a better game.
For ZNS Total Sports, I'm Charles Fisher.
All right, thanks a lot, Charles. Well, South Andres was the place to be during the Mother's Day weekend with the staging of the Mangrove Key Class C Regatta, and Whitty Kay continued her dominance, winning the overall title.
It's great, man. Wanuapi is a wonderful place. And people down here treat you real nice. And I love coming down here. And I love the wind down here, too.
What was the difference this regard? You was able to basically just demolish the competition?
Well, I told him from yesterday morning when we were by the boat, I told him, only way you're going to beat me is you got to outsmart me, and that ain't going to happen. Once you see I get in the front, it's hard for you to catch me.
Why are you so good?
Sir James, Lauren Knowles, the most winningest sailor in the history, got it. Susan Chase, that's my father. That's Sir James.
And that will do it for sports, but don't go anywhere. There's more to come after the break.
This is ZNS Total Sports, brought to you by 4th Terrace Diagnostic Center.